Hi guys, and welcome back to Movies That Matter with the Viking. It seems like every day there's a new article or post or YouTube video that says Ben Affleck's Batman is back. Well, technically, I've been saying over the last few months, Ben Affleck is back in the DCU. He's back as being Batman, because in 2021, we get to see him come back as Batman in Zack Snyder's Justice League. So technically, he is back. Even though he hasn't fully returned, he has sent a video to Kevin Smith thanking the fans, talking about Zack Snyder's Justice League. He has appeared at DC Fandom. So, in a way, Ben Affleck's Batman is back. But what all of us want to hear is him coming back for future projects after Zack Snyder's Justice League. Now, we got to see Ben Affleck in Batman vs. Superman. Unbelievable. Suicide Squad, he had a nice cameo. He's in a few scenes. Pretty well done. And then in Justice League, you know what happened there. But anyways, so he will be the Batman. Zack Snyder's Justice League will be his fourth time being Batman. I would just like to push Justice League out of the way and forget about that film altogether. But look, some people like it, some people don't. Some people have watched it. So you kind of have to do count it. But the question is, if Ben Affleck, if, big capital letter if he wants to come back to play Batman in future installments in any capacity, whether it be Zack Snyder's Justice League, that would be interesting. That would be pretty cool if that is a success. But people want to see Ben do his own movie or series. Now, a movie isn't going to come out in theaters because Robin Pattinson is the Batman, and that will be a trilogy, and I'm looking forward to it. So the place for Ben Affleck to return as Batman is on HBO Max. And HBO Max, again, I thank you for greenlitting Zack Snyder's Justice League and making that a reality, a dream, a reality. Unbelievable. So if Ben Affleck was to say yes, I want to come back as Batman, would it be a series or would it be a film? Either way, I don't think any of us would mind. We don't really care. We just want to see him come back. But him coming back as Batman depends on a number of things. For one, it depends on the success of Zack Snyder's Justice League. Now, in what capacity can Zack Snyder's Justice League be a success? Money-wise, it technically can't because there's no box office. So HBO Max aren't going to be worried about that. What they will be worried about is buzz, attraction, people getting the service, you know, registering with HBO Max. The buzz week to week, it's four episodes and then turn into a movie. So the buzz week to week online, that would be one success. And then people talking about it and engaging, theories on YouTube, all over social media. Then a season two could probably possibly be greenlit if they're willing to put $70 million right now into this project. It's hardly just for a one and done. But let's say Ben Affleck says, yes, I want to come back. Would it happen? Would the story take place after Zack Snyder's Justice League? Or would it take place before Batman v Superman Dawn of Justice? Me personally, before when it was announced that Ben Affleck was doing the Batman and he was the director, I always presumed that it would take place before Batman vs. Superman. I didn't think it was going to take place after BVS and before Justice League. I never thought that was going to happen, or I never thought it was going to take place after Justice League. I always kind of presumed in my own head that it was going to take place before Batman vs. Superman, because there's a lot of story to be told. 20 plus years of Gotham City history. 20 years of stuff that we don't even know what happened. Now you can go off the Dark Knight trilogy and kind of presume what happened and stuff like that. But in this world with Ben Affleck, with Jared Leto, with Deathstroke, we don't know exactly what happened. How long have Ben Affleck's Bruce Wayne and Lex Luthor known each other? Now that's pretty cool and intriguing for me also. But what would be the best way to bring back Ben Affleck? If it was his choice, if he wanted to do it, would it take place after Zack Snyder's Justice League? Or would it be its own thing before Superman arrived to the world and before all these super beings arrived, like Flash and Cyborg and Wonder Woman, before they were known? For me, I would like it to take place before Batman vs. Superman. I'll tell you why. I think there's so much story to be told. We've got the death of Robin, which Zack Snyder has said it's Dick Grayson, not Jason Todd. So that's a change from the comic books and from the history of Batman. We know that Joker is the one who killed Dick Grayson, killed him. It's not Margot Robbie's Harley Quinn. Jeff Johns changed that in Suicide Squad. David Ayer confirmed that. So there's so much story to tell just there. Also, how many battles of him and Deathstroke is there? Now, in Zack Snyder's Justice League, it might be changed, but there's a post-credits scene where Batman and Deathstroke are maybe going to go at. Because Joe Manganiello, who plays Deathstroke, said that the real post-credits scene can now exist. Now, does that mean the two of them are going to face off before they fight? Or is it just a different version of the Lex Luthor Deathstroke scene where Lex says, look, I want you to go kill the Batman. You know, he wouldn't kill Superman for me. I want you to go kill him. Maybe. But how many times have they fought before in the past? What other villains in this world have we not even known about that went up with Ben Affleck's Batman? Now, in Batman vs. Superman, there's a question mark on one of the piers when Batman is fighting Superman. So is that signs to the Riddler? Has the Riddler appeared in this world before? Has Ben Affleck's Batman gone up against the Riddler? Now, Jay Olivia is a storyboard artist, director of The Dark Knight Returns Part 1 and Part 2, other animated films as well. He said it's the best Batman script he has ever read. So it's truly a brilliant Batman script that Ben Affleck had in mind. And if that's the one that Ben Affleck still wants to go with, it's been rumored that that was kind of similar to the Arkham Asylum game, where Batman has to go through Arkham facing all his role gallery and taking on the Joker and things like that. Now, we don't know if that's fully confirmed or not. We don't know really what Ben Affleck's script was. I suppose another way you could tell the story is it takes place after Zack Snyder's Justice League, but Ben Affleck is looking back to the past. So you have him dealing with a mystery maybe, or something going on in today's world. But he's also being haunted by the memories, or maybe the story links up with stuff that happened in his past. Maybe that Jason Todd's storyline could be implemented where Dick Grayson is now Jason Todd. Maybe. Or maybe Jason Todd is appearing. There's so many possibilities of a Ben Affleck solo film or series happens on HBO Max, but it all depends on the success of Zack Snyder's Justice League. And also, it depends if Ben Affleck wants to do it himself. He might not want to. He might just want to fulfill the vision that Zack Snyder wanted to do back in 2017, and that's it. But remember, a lot of shit went down on the production of Zack Snyder's Justice League, and that turned Ben off the role, and also turned him off being Batman in his own solo film and directing that film. He'd stepped away. But things are changed. It's not Warner Brothers who are over these properties anymore. No. HBO Max, Warner Media officially have the Snyderverse. They do. And Zack Snyder's Justice League, for me personally, is the first of many. I think this will break off into many spin-offs. Maybe even the Zack Snyder's 5 story arc will be completed, which I hope so. And if enough money is thrown towards Ben Affleck, and after Zack Snyder's Justice League, if the buzz, like it was for Batman vs. Superman, is around Ben Affleck again, a huge social media buzz, then how can Ben Affleck turn his head at the money being offered also by the fan buzz? And he's a Batman fan. So, I think it all depends on the success of Zack Snyder's Justice League. For now, I don't think anything's going to be announced until that comes out. I really don't. I don't think any deals are going to be made. We know he's coming back for The Flash, but you hear rumors every day, articles every day, that Ben Affleck is officially back as Batman. While none of this stuff is coming from The Hollywood Reporter, none of this stuff is coming from Ben Affleck or Zack Snyder, I think we'll have to wait until Zack Snyder's Justice League. I hope I'm wrong, but a lot of it depends on how well that film does. And that's up to us. It's up to people out there, fans, the average audiences, to check it out. I think they will, because it has these huge properties. It has Batman, Wonder Woman, Superman. You know, people will want to see that, and if Zack gets to add more stuff to it, I think the marketing campaign for Zack Snyder's Justice League could be very, very interesting, and loads of other actors have been rumored to appear. But for me, Ben Affleck's solo adventure as Batman, I would hope it would take place before Batman vs. Superman, because there's so much history to be told. What drove Ben Affleck's Batman to be the way that he was in Batman vs. Superman? Was it just the arrival of Superman? Was it the death of Dick Grayson? Or was it other areas? His love interest? What really happened to this Batman? He is a complex, interesting character that Batman vs. Superman showed us a lot of elements of his character but didn't dive deep into it. The only element that really dived deep into it was maybe the glimpse at the Robin costume, but also the Martha moment, which is a very, very interesting idea from Zack Snyder and Chris Terrio. But what other things made Ben Affleck's Batman be this way? Was it just the death of his parents? I don't think so. I think there's more to it. I think Ben Affleck, who was a great director, and if you watch The Way Back, has still got it as in terms of acting chops, could give us an extraordinary story set in Gotham City. The Suicide Squad is having a spin-off. The Batman is having a spin-off. So why not Zack Snyder's Justice League? And for that one spin-off to happen, I think Ben Affleck's Batman could be a huge possibility. It's not going to be Wonder Woman. It's not going to be Aquaman. Those are theatrical experiences that are there to make big money. Cyborg could cost a lot of money. And Flash is having his solo film. So if a spin-off movie was to happen, who would it happen with? Ben Affleck's Batman is my choice, and Ben Affleck's Batman is my prediction. And I've said this for a very long time, ever since Zack Snyder's Justice League got announced, I think that it was a huge possibility that Zack Snyder could tempt Ben Affleck to come back as Batman in some capacity. HBO Max could tempt him to come back in some capacity. And money talks, and also fan buzz talks also. We've done campaigns, events for Ben Affleck's Batman where we have shown him appreciation and showed him love. I'm sure he has seen it. But we'll have to wait, guys. So let me know. The story for Ben Affleck's Batman, if he was to return, would you want it to take place in an isolated Gotham City where there is no Superman, there is no Wonder Woman, there is no meta-humans, there is just Ben Affleck's Batman, and dealing with some sort of mystery, dealing with his rogue gallery, the Joker, Deathstroke, Penguin, Riddler, these type of characters? Or would you want it to take place after Zack Snyder's Justice League and have more of a supernatural tone to it? Maybe dealing with more parademons. Maybe dealing with more beings that have powers. Or maybe a mystery that takes place in today's world but links to his past memories and maybe past failures. But pretty interesting. But guys, let me know your thoughts. What do you want to see? Give a like, comment, subscribe. Come follow me on all the social medias. And Ben Affleck's Batman will return in 2021 in Zack Snyder's Justice League. He will return in 2022 for the Flash solo film. What will 2023 or 2024 bring for the Dark Knight?